PEX pipe or PEX pipe? Which one is it? Well, I know everyone's confused, and I'm hoping with this video that I can clear up some assumptions and some ideas of what everyone think, what type of PEX pipe is what. So yes, there are two different types of PEX. You have the PEX pipe, and then you have PEX tubing, and each one uses a different type of fitting. And it is kind of confusing. You have Zurn PEX and you have Uponor PEX. Now, Uponor PEX is the one that I use. So with that in mind, let's get started. Hello, I'm Claude Taylor and this is the How To Plumbing Channel. Welcome to all my subscribers, welcome back. And if you are new to this video, I hope you enjoy it. And if you do, give it a thumbs up and become a subscriber. Also, if you'd like to see more videos in the future, hit that notification bell. Thank you. Starting off, you can see that we have two different types of tool. One is for PEX tubing and the other one's going to be for the PEX pipe. This one here that we're looking at real close, that was for the PEX tubing, and this is going to be for the PEX pipe. This one expands the pipe, and the other just crimps the ring around the pipe itself. This is the one that I use the most. This here I don't use at all. So those are crimp rings, and there's also a different tool for that, and you can use those on PEX tubing. But I, you know, personally wouldn't recommend, because I've been in houses that had them and I had to replace them. They tend to rust out. This one here, these rings here are made for the PEX tubing, and also known as Zurn. So these are like Zurn fittings, and Zurn, we're gonna use Zurn PEX pipe with it. They're just small little copper rings. You can't see the copper because they're coated with some black coating, but they're little copper rings that are compressed, compressing the pipe between the fitting and the ring itself. This is a PEX tubing fitting. It's going to look almost exactly like the Uponor. So I wouldn't try to use one without I wouldn't try to use the Uponor with the PEX tubing or the Zurn with the Uponor. And these are the different sizes, from 3/8 and 3/4. It goes all the way up to 1 inch. And we already have 1/2 inch inserted. And again, this is the that was the one for the Zurn, and this here is for the Uponor. This is the Uponor ring. Unlike the other ring, this one here will expand. The tool that I use will expand that ring and the pipe itself. And you can see right here, this is the Uponor fitting. I'll hold them up next to each other shortly here so that you can see the difference. Again, you don't want to use that with the PEX tubing. And this is the Uponor tool that I use to expand the pipes, and it goes from 1/2 inch up to 1 inch, this particular set here, but you can get some that'll go up to 2 inch and even as small as 3/8. And if you also notice, they have them color coded. And this is the 1/2 inch. This is the one we're going to use in the video, the 1/2 inch. Now you can see them side by side. The one on the left is Uponor and the one on the right is the Zurn fitting. And you can see they almost look identical, but if you look a little closer, you'll see the difference. Now, this is the Uponor that I'm picking up. And this here is the Zurn. I mean, if you go to Home Depot or Lowe's, you can now, right here, I want to show you something real quick. You can see the diameter of the Uponor is a little wider than the diameter of the Zurn. This is another reason I do like to use the Uponor, because you have more of an opening and you don't have that water restriction. And again, I don't know if you've heard my other videos, sometimes inspectors may frown on you using the Zurn because they want as much water flow as possible without the restriction. And to operate the tool is pretty much explanatory, and you can see the animated drawing that they have there. As I was saying earlier, I don't know if you missed it, but I was talking about the purchasing the Zurn fittings. Most of the Zurn fittings, you can pick them up at Home Depot or Lowe's. You're not really going to find Uponor there unless you, the only time you're going to find Uponor is less, it's at a plumbing supply house or a Uponor dealer that deals with Uponor PEX pipe and fittings. Not only looking at the diameter of the inside, you can see that the Uponor is a little more massive and a little, seems to be a lot stronger to me personally. And this pipe here, this is the PEX pipe. PEX pipe. This is Uponor. This is PEX tubing. I've got 300 feet of this if anybody needs it. The mistake I made is I ordered the, thought I was ordering PEX pipe. I seen a deal that said, hey, you can get it at this price, but I didn't pay attention to the PEX tubing, so I got 300 extra feet that I don't need. And you can see the difference. The Uponor is a little glossier, kind of shiny, and it has like a little white frosting on the inside of it. And they like to call it a memory pipe, and the reason they say memory because when it's pushed out and flared out, it comes back, it remembers and comes right back to its original form, and that's when it squeezes real tight around the fittings. Now this is the Zurn. Back to the Zurn. You see the fitting will go right inside the Zurn without opening it up or anything. It'll just slip right in there. And that's a half inch opening. So that goes to show you that you're going to lose a little bit of depth there. Now, I'm not going to say Zurn's a bad pipe, because I did run Zurn at one time until I really, what it was is the. Uponor tools at the time was so expensive that a lot of plumbers really wasn't doing a lot of Uponor, and this tubing, the PEX tubing, was a lot cheaper and easier to do and run with it, as far as a tool anyway. But once I got that tool, that's all I wanted to run. Now I'm going to show you another little, I'm going to show you a little trick here that I used to do when I did run the Zurn pipe here. Now you see how the little ring just slides right down. So what we want to do is prevent that from happening so that when you're in a tight space, it doesn't slide down on you, because it can be frustrating. So what I'm going to do is take the little copper ring. Again, this is copper. And just kind of give it a little egg shape. And now it should squeeze nice and tightly on the PEX tubing without sliding down. And per their recommendations, when you do install these, to leave just a small part of that blue showing. You don't want to put the ring totally up against the fitting itself. And that toolkit that I got right there for this particular pipe here, I got it like in 2016, and it's I really didn't use it. I just kept it just in case I ran into a house that I had need to do work on, and all they had was a Zurn pipe, so it came in handy every now and then to do repairs. And the point I was getting at, the price of this tool here compared to the other one. This one here I picked up at, Lowe's or Home Depot, one of them. It was like 70-some-odd bucks, which is a good price for a tool like this. Compared to the Uponor, which spent close to 400 bucks for that one. And one thing with the Uponor, it's a little more versatile than this one when you're working in tight spots, and especially when it's battery operated, powered. Now, usually this is not that difficult, but I'm trying to give you a good angle on the camera so that you can see it. This is really not that hard of a tool to operate, actually. It may seem hard right now watching this video. That's only because I'm trying to give you the best view of it that I can on the operation of it. And once we get it in place where we want it, all we're going to do is just squeeze it together. It's pretty hard, but to squeeze together anyway, but that's how this works. And now that brass fitting is on there tight. So if your home right now, if you have a home that's ran and you see a lot of little black rings, that's the Zurn pipe that they're using on your plumbing system. And this is another tool. This is a tool to gauge. Once you've crimped that ring on there, you just put that tool, and if it goes over it, the size that that you need, this is half inch. And if the half inch goes over fairly clear, you know that you've made a nice connection. See, that's it. So you know that it squeezed itself down. Okay, now this is the Uponor, and this is the Uponor pipe, Uponor fitting, and the tool for Uponor piping. Now you notice this doesn't go inside the pipe, and the diameter of the inside of that fitting is the same diameter as the inside of the pipe. And this is the ring that we're going to use, the expandable ring. For some reason they call it a blueprint ring. I don't understand it, but. And this one here, you see it has a stop so it won't slide down the pipe. There's a little slot stop built on the end of it. So that's as far as it's going to go. And again, the different size heads that we have for the Uponor tool. Every now and then, it comes with some grease. Every now and then, you want to grease it up because of it when it's dry, that head won't open and expand it for you. Okay, now to expand, and now it's slowly squeezing back down on the pipe, making a nice tight connection. And the good thing about this, that you'll be able to turn the water on right away. Again, this is the How To Plumbing Channel. I am Claude Taylor. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. And if you're not a subscriber, become one. Also, hit that notification button so that you can get the latest videos coming out. Thank you.